نعره حیدری،
جاری،
نعره غوثیه، حضور شهزاده غوث الورا، حضور شهزاده غوث الورا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك وتحنن وتمنن على الحبيب المصطفى، طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك وتحنن وتمنن على الحبيب المصطفى بقدر ذرات التراب والرمل والحصى وجريان الماء والهواء، نحمده ونستعين به إلى أن نلقاه وهو راض عنا غير غضبان. الحمد لله الذي يجمعنا وإياكم في هذا المكان المبارك الذي ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعل دائما تجمعنا هذا تجمعا مباركا مرحوما مرزوقا مغفورا، وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا مرحوما إن شاء الله. جو محمد درميان أنبياء، غوث أعظم درميان أولياء. الحمد لله، today in the blessing programs, the program belong to the Sultan al-Awliya, belong to the one of the blood, Ali Bayt Rasulullah. Allama sahab, when a few minutes they say, وَلَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا لِلْمُوَدَّةِ فِي الْقُرْبَى. And when they say, who made the my family is happy, that is meaning I am happy and Allah is happy. And the Muslim, when he wants to complete his iman, Sayyidina Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said about the iman, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من نفسه وماله وولده وأهله والناس أجمعين، أو كما قال عند بخاري. The meaning is to love the Ali Bayt Rasulullah, to take Ali Bayt Rasulullah to the Awliya and the Salihin, belong to the Ali Bayt Rasulullah, that as a way and the wasila, as in the Holy Quran, وَبْتَغُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ الْوَسِيلَ. Choose the way to be near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is a lot of way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Awliya and the Salihin, that is a way to guide you, the way to guide you and to take you to show you where is the light from the dark. A lot of people, they have an iman, but they are not complete the character of the iman. Akhlaq, that is the meaning tasawwuf. And the Imam al-Shafi'i rahmatullah alayhi said, kullama zuddani akhlaqan faqad zuddani tasawwufan. How much you have given me character, that is meaning you have increased my tasawwuf is more. The character, this is the way and the very important note in the tasawwuf. And the Sayyidina Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. So everything mentioned, the hadith and the book of the Holy Quran. Then the knowledge of the Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jailani, he has received it because of his blood belonged to the Imam Sayyidina Al-Hasan, father said, and Imam Sayyidina Al-Husayn, mother said. And he said to the all the awliya, مقامكم العلا جمعا ولكن مقامي ما زال فوقكم عاج. All the awliya, they have a big place, higher place, but still my place is bigger than you. Why? Because I am Al-Hasan, you are Al-Husayni, and my Nana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, when we said about the awliya and the salihin, first thing Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jailani, when he said in the Urdu, in the Friday prayer, it was more than 300 wali sitting listening to the Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani advice. That time he said, وَقَدَمِي هَذِهِ عَلَىٰ رَقَبَةِ كُلِّ وَلِيُّ اللَّهِ أَوْ أَوْلِيَاءُ اللَّهِ. يعني in the Urdu, مَيَا رَقَدَمْ تَمَامْ أَوْلِيَاءِ كِي گَرْدَمْ پَرْهِ. That time, the Imam al-Rifa'i, Ahmed al-Rifa'i, rahmatullah alayhi, when he heard and he listened, he said, Ya Ghawth, my neck, it will be first neck for your neck. My neck, it will be first neck for your neck. And the second, Khaja Muhyiddin Chishti rahmatullah alayhi, he said, Ya Ghawth, abt qadam, mera gardan niya, mera aakuka, sar paraspar. He said, Your feet, it is not only in my neck, but in my eyes and my head from the top. What is the meaning, the qadam and the feet? The qadam and the feet of the knowledge of Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jailani have received from his Nana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Bil-ilm and al-ma'rifah, by the knowledge. That is the, when the Sayyidina say, Mera qadam is bigger, why? Because of my knowledge is bigger than me. One day, there is a king in Morocco, in the time of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, king of Morocco. He had to give divorce, talaq, for his wife 3 times. In that time of the talaq, he was angry and he said, you will not become my wife. Sorry, not 3 times, he gave the talaq for his wife and he said to her, you will not become my wife again till I will do the ibadah. Nobody have done this ibadah before me. Even Rasulullah, he never done it. But after, when he become called, he asked and he called all the ulama and mufti in that time, please, I have said this, I have to do ibadah, nobody have done it. Till my wife, she become again. And she's my wife, she's the mother of my children, and I want to call her again. So all the mufti and alim, they say, what is that ibadah? Even Rasulullah, he never made it. We don't have an answer. 1 year, 2 years, after 7 years, he's searching for that ibadah, he's searching for the answer for his question. Meaning he's searching for a fatwa. He never find, till one day, when his friend, he was a businessman, when he visited him, he saw him, he was upset and angry, and he asked him why, he said, because of this reason. I said, my wife, she will not come back to me till when I will do the ibadah, and that ibadah, even Rasulullah, he never made it. So what is that? He said, maybe the answer or the fatwa, it is hard, but I was in Iraq, in Baghdad, and I see there the big waliullah at this time, and you have to go there, and my belief is nobody have been to him, he come back without the answer. Always there is answer. He said, but it's far. He said, you want to answer, it is there. You want something cheap, you stay here. You want to take expensive, you have to go there. So he arranged some group and qafila, some army, and he went there to the mazar of Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir in the place called Bab al-Sheikh. That place before is called Bab al-Azad, changed. So the names of Bab al-Sheikh belong to the name of Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Gailani. So Bab al-Sheikh, it is a famous place in Baghdad now. And not in Baghdad, but all the world. When they say Bab al-Sheikh, they know this is the place of Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Gailani. He went to him and he said, I have come here because of some, I need a fatwa, I need a help, I need an answer. What is the answer? And what is your question for the answer? He said, I have met and I have said to my wife, you will not come again halal to me till when I will do ibadah, even that ibadah, no Rasulullah have made it. You have an answer? So Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, when he listened to his question, he said, yes, it is very easy answer. Very easy. He said, what is the easy? I have spent more than 7 years waiting for the answer, for the fatwa. He said, you are not a normal. You are not a normal person, you are a king. So if you will go to the Mecca and you ask Mufti of Mecca to allow you, Mufti of Mecca, to allow you to do tawaf and the Khana Ka'bah 7 times alone, that is the ibadah even Rasulullah, he never made it before you. Now the answer is very easy, but the time of the question was very hard, and nobody can thinking about this. But Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani immediately he gave him his answer and the fatwa to make his wife again halal to him. Today, when we are sitting in this beautiful gathering arrangement by Hajji Qamar al-Zaman, Allah yubarak bihi inshaAllah, wa yaj'alhu fi khidmat al-Islam wal-Muslimin. And always we remember him in Baghdad because there is one Qadi, his name is Nur al-Zaman. And I used to tell him the name about Nur al-Zaman and Qamar al-Zaman. And Qamar always shining, inshaAllah. And the Qamar is from the Nur, because Qamar without Nur, there is no light. So when we are here arranging this gathering by the Khadim Al-Hajj Qamar Al-Zaman Al-Qadim, because he's a Khadim Al-Awliya'i Wa-Salihin and the Khadim Ali Bayt Rasulullah. And this is the work for all the Sahabat of Sayyidina Rasul. They like to be khidmah in the feet of Ali Bayt Rasulullah. They like to be, everybody have the aqidah for Sayyidina Rasulullah. They should have aqidah for his family of Sayyidina Rasulullah. Because in your prayer in Durood al-Ibrahimi, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala Ali Sayyidina Muhammadin. If the Ali Sayyidina Rasulullah not a very important and high daraja and martaba, Allah will not order all the Muslims whenever they are in the West, East, Maghrib, Mashriq, he have to say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala Ali Sayyidina Muhammadin. So this is the khidmat from arrange this gathering. And this program, always, whenever I go anywhere in this place, in this world, not in Europe only, anywhere in Asia and Africa, I say, remember today, this program, it was not arranged by chance, but it is arranged by the arrangement. The arrangement from Baghdad, from Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani to be here. To be here in this place, to see, to talk, to listen, to pray. So it is the arrangement, it is not by the chance, but by the arrangement from the Awliya Allah and the Sultan al-Awliya, Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, to visit this place, to be in this place, to arrange this place, to arrange a program in this place. 2 weeks before, I like to mention something. I was sitting in the Astana and some murid is here. I asked him, give the speech for your trip in Baghdad. Last time, he been in Baghdad in the last week of Ramadan and with me. He say, of course, when he was talking with the Muridin and they say, when I am there with the Sheikh Saab, with me meaning, so whenever I go, there is a different respect and different law. Even the day of the 27th of Laylatul Qadr, we have made the Khatam and Dhikr Qadri in the special room called Khulwat Room of Ghosbar Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. And that room never opened to anyone, only when we go there. So he understands, he said, because of the Sheikh Saab, the room has opened. And because of the Sheikh Saab, there is order for us to sit there and to make the Khatam and Dhikr for the, in the Ramadan time, in the 27th of Laylatul Qadr, because of the Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, give us permission and arrangement to be in his room. First day of the Eid, we was the first people to be enter inside the Jali, to stay with the Jali, to pray near to the Jali of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani because of the Hassan. That is the meaning, there is arrangement and the order of Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani to pray near to him. Meaning there is a wasila. It says, if I will be not with the Ghosbak son, I will not can enter first one. I cannot sit in that room even. There is a lot of Muridin when they been to the Baghdad, they want, maybe they do ziyarah in the Jali, but they have still law and like omniya to be inside the Jali of Ghosbak to put some chadar. So they have trying, but without yani any chance, but they will be the day of the arrangement to be with them and to put the cover chadar of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. That is meaning it was the arranged already by the Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani to be there inside of the Jali Mubarak of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. And that is also by the wasila. So all this by the arrangement, it was not by the chance, but your time will come, then you will understand. Everybody have knows. Like somebody, he was bimar. And he went to the operation. And after operation, he become okay. So when you ask him how you become shifa, he said from Allah. Okay. After Allah, he said, the doctor, he have given me the shifa. So meaning without doctor, you will not still alive. The doctor, he, Allah have arranged him as a wasila to help you. So there is everything, fa'il wa maf'ul, fi'il wa fa'il. So arrange to arrange and to be arranged. Alhamdulillah wa shukru, when we say again, we are in this place with a lot of muridin and lover of Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir, that is meaning lover of awliya and the salihin. Because all the awliya and the salihin, they are under the feet of the Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani. And then when they say, Mera qadam tamam awliya akhira tampari, everybody put his hand, his head is down like this. Meaning they are accept of the order. And that time it was the Jum'ah. When they went to the lunch, in the table, it was a lot of food. Then when they drink and they eat, Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir left some food and drink in his plate. So when he left his place, all the awliya and the bigger awliya of that time, they went to the plate of Shaykh Abdul Qadir and cup of the water, what is left? They want to take some drink or drop of that water or some food, what is left in his plate. So Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani saw him and he mentioned in his Al-Qasid Al-Ghawthir. They say, Sharuktum fudlati min ba'di sukri, walakin lanutum uluwi watisali. He say, you have a drink and you eat what I have left, but you will not reach my contact in my place. This is the Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa ardah, his speech and his announcement with all the awliya and the salihin in that time. Alhamdulillah wa shukr, when we are following the tariqah of Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani and all the tariqah, but because we are talking about the tariqah al-Qadiriyya, this is meaning the tariqah Ali Bayt Rasulullah, Imam Sayyidina al-Hasan and Imam Sayyidina al-Husayn, and Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, for his family they will be like a river. Till the Qiyamah they will be not stopped. So Alhamdulillah, you are following the river of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nas'al Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yuwaffiqna wa yuwaffiq jami' al-jama'at al-hadirin fi hadha al-makan wa ala al-qa'imin fi hadha al-amal khasatan wa khususan Allah muwaffiq wa barik ila al-haj qamar al-zaman al-qadri lima tahubu wa tardahu ya arhamur rahimin arihi tariq al-haq haqqa warzuq ala itiba'ah وطريق الباطل باطلا وجنبه على اتباعه واخر دعوانا ان الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاه والسلام على خاتم الانبياء والمرسلين والسلام
لله يا عبد القادر محي الدين في القلب حاضر محي الدين في القلب حاضر جيلاني بالله ماهر جيلاني بالله ماهر المدد يا عبد القادر المدد يا عبد القادر المدد يا عبد القادر يا نبي سلام عليك يا رسول سلام عليك يا حبيب سلام عليك صلوات الله عليك صلوات الله
والسلام على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين. اللهم لا تدع في مجلسنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته آمين. ولا عيبا إلا سترته آمين. ولا هما إلا فرجته آمين. ولا فقيرا إلا رزقته آمين. اللهم ولا مريضا إلا شافيته آمين. ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة إلا قضيتها لنا يا أرحم الراحمين. دعوناك اللهم كما أمرتنا فاستجب لنا كما وعدتنا يا أرحم الراحمين. لا تردنا بعد الدعاء من الخائبين، ولا من بابك من المطرودين، ولا من رحمتك من اليائسين. تقبل دعانا ببركة الأنبياء والأولياء والصالحين. اللهم خاصة وخصوصا سيدنا القطب الرباني والهيكل الصمداني، سيدنا الغوث الأعظم أبي محمد المحيي الدين عبد القادر الجيلاني.